In this tutorial, I will show you three ways to load real data in HD files: load data from local drives, load data from Google Sheets, and load data from JSON. And at the end of this video, I will show you how I fetched live data in coronavirus dashboard without writing a single line of code. So let's start. From last couple of years, we are using boring dummy placeholder data like lorem ipsum. No one understands that, and our all designs looks boring. So now it's time to load some real data from APIs, that is application programming interface, into our design so they can look more authentic and more realistic. For these projects, I have used repeat grid feature in XD. So before jumping into loading data, we should know what repeat grid is. As a designer, we often use repeated components like list, cards, thumbnails, etc. And styles are the same and contents are unique. Take example of YouTube and WhatsApp. In designs like this, we need to repeat style of subheading, caption, and description. It's a tedious job to enter data manually. So when you design mockups like this, use repeat grid option. Select single or group of elements and press Ctrl R. Drag horizontally or vertically to increase rows and columns. Use red guideline to reduce and increase space between rows and columns. Double click to edit the content. Now you can see you can edit content of one element without affecting the others. And also when you change style of one element, it will change others. To ungroup repeat grid, click right side mouse button and select ungroup grid. Now all elements are separate and you have to select each element to change style. How we can insert data into repeat grid? The first method I would like to show you, that is load data from your hard drive. For this method, you must prepare data in advance. I want to load movie poster, movie name, and movie information. You can see we have images and plain text files. Movie information contains movie types, ratings, release date, and duration. Movie name contains all the movies I want in design list. Just drag the content in OpenXD file. Now you can see the data is updated in XD file. We are all familiar with the Google Sheets. They are like Excel sheets. You can use ReadyOne or you can create your own. To do this, we need a plugin called Google Sheets. Go to Plugins, Manage Plugins, click Browse, and search for Google Sheets. Click Install. I have created a Google Sheet for this tutorial where I have headings like category, image location, and likes. I want to load this data in XD file. So open your XD document and rename layers with the same name of Google Sheet heading. In Google Sheet, click on Share, Copy Link, come to XD document, select all elements, go to Plugins. In Paste URL, paste link and click Continue. Now you can see XD layer name at left and Google Sheet headings at the right. These headings have similar names. Select Randomize Content to load data in random order and click Apply. all the data is loaded, and when you change data in Google Sheets, it's automatically get updated in XD. Now let's talk about loading data from JSON file. JSON is a syntax of storing and exchanging data. Don't worry about the syntax, just focus on variable to load data. There are many free APIs available online. You can download or use online link. I will mention the list in description below. For this example, we are going to use data populator plugin. We have movie JSON saved on my local drive. Variables are at the left hand side and values are at the right. We just have to use variable name for our layers inside the XD document. Copy variable name and go to XD. Select layer and in layer panel paste inside the curly brackets. Make this for all layers where you want to load dynamic data. To load images, use shapes. Go to plugins, data populator, select populate with JSON, select movie.json file. And click populate. Now you can see the data is loaded from JSON file within fraction of seconds. This is definitely a time saver. Now let's load some live data. I have created a COVID-19 dashboard to show worldwide data. This plugin helped me to fetch the real data. I found this URL online and it's free to use and you get live updates. You can paste URL inside the browser to check whether it is working or not. It's working. You can see variable names. Same we can use in our XD files. Another way to find variable name is select element and go to plugin, data populator and select populate from URL. Paste in URL section and click load. Now you can see variable names at the left hand side and values at the right hand side. You can write this variable name or you can take screenshot of it and use the same name for your layers. I want to load flag that is inside the country info object. So use opening curly bracket country info dot flag and close curly bracket. And for country, write country inside the curly brackets and so on. Click populate. Now you can see the data is loaded, but we want more data to load inside the list, so we are going to use repeat grid. Press Ctrl R, drag it vertically. Again go to plugins, data populate, populate from URL and click populate. Now all the data is loaded. Now you want to scroll the list and other elements should be fixed. So select all elements except list and select fixed position from right panel. I have overlapped this rectangle to hide some part of list when I scroll. Go to prototype, drag blue arrow towards another artboard, select drag. Now you can see our dashboard is ready with dynamic data. I'm coming with more tutorial like this. Please subscribe to get alerts and also don't forget to like and comment.